Hello, folks. Welcome to Lester's Custom Truck Shop. James O. This is your DX2547. James has been really patient with me. And because of that, I've upgraded him from an LC35128 to an LC35192. And you now have a band switch where the 9 normal 19 switch was. This is now your band switch. Okay. Oh, yeah. Might help if I move my hand so you can see. Okay. All right, and also there's your 10-turn clarifier. Got that installed in the original clarifier position. And what that did was free up this clarifier button that comes on the DX2547. So what I use that for is the plus 10kc switch. Push that in, you see we jump up 10kc's, okay? That way you got all the control right here in the front. You got your band switch there and the 10kc switch right there. Alright, now your clarifier. Let me get on channel 40. Okay, right there we're on center slot. Let me show you how far this thing goes up. It goes up 10kc's all the way up to 415. Okay. You can see it goes down almost 9 kc's. That's like 18.7 kc a slide. That was another thing that I gave you because you've been so patient. I upgraded you to the Lescom Deluxe Clarifier. There's only a few people that know how to do this. I've shared it with two other shops. Bells in Fort Lauderdale and Tim over at Snake Radio Customs, because they buy a lot of kits from me. I've shared the Lescom Deluxe clarifier with them. Nobody else can do that. But anyway, that's where I'm at right now. I'm not sure that's going to be the permanent spot for your board, your LC35192. We may move it somewhere else. I've got to install the Echo, and your Echo control is going to go where the headphones are. I think where the headphone jack was. Let's see. Yeah, Deluxe Echo and headphone jack position. Okay, so Echo control will go there. And you'll lose your headphone jack. But that's where I'm at. Okay, more to come. Okay, James. It is James, isn't it? Hang on a second. Yeah. James O. Got your new filter in. The 15 kilohertz wide filter. I've upgraded the first RF amp. And because this is a base station, I was able to get a 6800 microfarad count back there where the DC comes in to act as like a filter or a little battery, so that when you're really driving the radio, you get a little bit of backup action there in case the power supply droops. And there's the voltage buffer filter for the voltage regulator. Okay, your radio already had the blue shot keys in it, so I didn't need to change those. Yeah, I know you didn't order the Lescom upgrades, but there again, because you waited so long and been so patient, I'm throwing all this stuff in for free. Okay, just like rewiring that clarifier switch, you know, I'm not going to charge you for any of that. I'm just going to throw it in. I appreciate your patience. All right, continuing on. Okay, There's your white LED in the meter. Got it held in with hot glue. Now, I've told you guys before, all you got to do is take a little alcohol and put around the hot glue and it'll turn loose or whatever it's stuck to. It's pretty easy to get off after that. Okay, but there it is. And it looks really good in the meter. I like the white LED in the meter. Okay, more to come. Okay, James O, I'm back. Another thing I was going to give you is the Top Gun CP1. And some of you may be wondering why I'm giving James all this stuff. James sent his radio in to me. I think it was around September or October of last year. I'd have to look back at the date on the package. But he had a noise problem on channel 38 and 39. And it was significant. It was a pretty bad problem. You couldn't talk sideband. And the problem really should not have taken me as long as it did to find. I mean, I know about switching power supplies, and they cause noise, but I'd never seen a 2547 with a noisy power supply, but that's what it turned out to be. This is a new power supply here, but it's under warranty. Galaxy went ahead and replaced it for me. But that's what the noise problem turned out to be, was a noisy switching power supply. But, you know, I mean, I looked all inside the radio for it, trying to figure out what it was, because I thought that it was some kind of oscillator problem inside the radio, because it was only on channel 38 and 39. Well, as it turns out, it was harmonics from this guy here that was causing that. Not from this one, but from the one that was in there. So that's all resolved now. I'm on to the mods. But because James' radio has been here so long, that's why I'm giving him all of these extras. But problems like that, I just have to work on them for a while, you know. Work on them a day or two and then set the radio aside, because if I just continue on, I'll just wind up making things worse. And you know, if I charge by the hour for all the troubleshooting time I spent on here, it would far outweigh what the radio is worth. So what I do, I work on it for a little while. If I'm not making any progress, I set it aside. Clear my head, you know, go work on something else. And then a couple of days later, come back to it and see if you got any new ideas what's causing it. But it's all resolved now. And again, it should have dawned on me to try my DC power supply. And I didn't. I kept running it on AC, looking for a problem. And then one day I just happened to not bring out the power cord. I had put the power cord up. And so I quickly connected it to my DC supply, switched to DC. Lo and behold, the damn problem was gone. So that's the way it goes. I mean, sometimes you win some, sometimes you don't. But that helped me figure out what the problem was. And when we got the new power supply in, put it in, boy, it cleaned right up. No more noise on 38 and 39. So that's the scenario behind that deal. All right. Okay, James, there's your Deluxe Echo board. It's made by Ranger. And I told you I'm going to throw in the Top Gun CP1. Okay. All right. More to come. Okay, James, there's your Top Gun Tech CP1 compressor. Okay, got it all hot glued to the bottom of the board there. It's insulated anyway. They coat it with like epoxy. But anyway, wanted to show you that. All right, more to come. Okay, James O. in Connecticut. Almost done. I got to put the knobs and everything back on. I was calibrating the different modes, making sure they're all lined up on center frequency. I've already showed you the clarifier, the range of the clarifier. Now this knob, it's going to have a little bit of glue on it, but there's no teeth. In other words, the 10-turn clarifier knob is just a smooth knob. But I wanted to use the same kind of knob, so what I do is take a quarter-inch drill bit and I drill out the inside to get rid of the teeth. And then I put just a touch of glue on it and slide it up on the shaft. Okay, so it's good and tight. I mean, it's not going to come off real easy. Okay, I got the noise filter on. Let's see, where's the noise blanker? A&L. Okay. See, boy, I like that. That Galaxy noise filter knocks out all that hash. But anyway, let's do a power check. Hello, audio. Audio 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. That is 48 watts peak. We're dead keying 20. Audio, hello, hello, audio. Audio 1, 2. Goes up to about 24 on RMS. Hello, audio. Audio 1, 2. All right, now let's switch to sideband. Hello, audio. Audio 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Audio test. That's pretty doggone good for a single final radio. And yes, it is single final. All you guys want to argue with me about it, God damn it. This is a driver. Okay? Driver. It's not a final. The two that go right here are the finals. So if I say single final, that means one final transistor. You don't include the driver when you're talking about the finals. If it has two finals, one there and one there, then it's a dual final radio. Okay, crackheads. I get tired of explaining things to people sometimes. A lot of them are just really either dense or their elevator don't go all the way to the top. This is not dual finals. This is a single final radio. All right. I'm off that soapbox. Okay. I'm about done with it, James. Got to put the knobs and everything back on it. Put the covers back on there, and I'll do one final check to make sure. And we'll be done. There's your echo control. Well, here, let me turn that on real quick so you can hear that. Let me see. My own AM. Nope. Hello.
Hello.
Audio, hello.
Audio, hello.
Hello, audio.
Hello, audio.
Hello,
audio.
1, 2. 3, 2.
1, 2, 3, 4.
All right. Now I'm going to turn the... Leave that turned up. Audio. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now I sound like a trucker. Okay. I'm going to cut that off. You can play with that like you want to. Here's your band switch. Okay. See, the radio will go all the way down to 26065. And it's got pretty good output power down there, too. Audio, hello, hello, audio, 1, 2, 1, 2, audio. Still doing about 40 watts on the lowest channel. Now, your highest channel is that one right there. Audio, hello, hello, audio, audio, 1-2, 1-2, audio, audio, 1-2. You can see it actually does better on the higher free band channels than it does on that low channel down there. Okay. All right, I'm going to put you back on the 11 meter band. And you can change it around like you want it. I'm going to set it on 38. Let me get all the knobs and stuff put back on it, and I'll be right back. More to come. James O. Okay, she's all done. I've got the screws loosely back in the case. Okay, I've learned not to zip down all the screws until after the testing is done. But it's got to go through the 24-hour burn-in test. Want to make sure it works when you get it. So it's late Thursday, the 30th of March. It's almost 7 o'clock. It's still daylight outside. I couldn't believe it. I mean, almost 8 o'clock. 7:45, 19:45. But about 8 o'clock tomorrow night, Friday night, I should know whether or not everything's working like it ought to. So I'm going to take it off my regular bench and move it over to the test table and hook it up and let it sit there and burn in for 24 hours. But other than that, it's done. This will be the last video unless there's a problem. And if there's a problem, I'll make a short video of that and explain what I did to correct it. But I don't foresee a problem. Just remember that this button right here is your plus 10 KC switch. This guy here is your band switch, okay? And there where your headphones were is where your echo control is now. You see I got matching knobs on that to match all the rest of it. That's what you pay for when you get the deluxe kit. All right. And of course your PA doesn't work anymore because we robbed the headphone jack and they're all interconnected, so that's all undone. And you notice when you hit the plus 10 KC button, see it jump up there? Now that frequency counter is going to flicker. This thing is warming up because I just got it put back together. But once it gets warm, it's very stable. Now it's got one of my crystals in it, and they're a lot more stable than the ones that come from Galaxy. The ones that come from Galaxy, they'll slide a lot, but they're not very stable. They drift all over the place. The ones that I've got are that I had made for this radio have a very high tolerance. And what that does is prevent it from moving around so much. Okay? All right. James, I sure hope you enjoy your radio. It was my pleasure to modify it for you. 7-3s, everybody.